What's going on, peeps? It's your boy St. Joe, soundsagear.com, checking in with you again. I want to talk to you about Ableton Live. A lot of people ask me what DAW I use. I'm not talking about beat machines and, you know, all the other different type of things I use, but I'm talking about specifically a DAW. They ask me if I use Reason, if I use FL Studio, do I use Reaper, do I use, you know, saying Cakewalk, do I use whatever, Logic, all this stuff, Cubase, Nuendo, anything you could think of. I tell them no. I tried, when I was making the transition from hardware to software, I tried tons and tons of DAWs. Only one I did not try was Logic, because I'm not using the Mac. I have an older Mac, and I had Digital Performer on there, so I tried that one too, but they all look the same. They look like this. I don't know about you, but if you're coming from an MPC or an ASR or an MV88 or any of these things, you know, SP12, you're not used to making beats linearly. You used to making beats in a pattern. You used to making a pattern, you build a pattern, you build a loop, 4-bar, 8-bar, 16-bar loop, whatever. You copy that to the next slot, then you add or take away from it, however, but you used to building stuff in patterns. So that's how my mindset works, and that's how I'm used to building tracks. So I wanna show you how Ableton Live is the only one that does that currently. That works that way. So basically, I want to show you what it took for me to understand it, and what anytime I tell my boys or anybody that's used to MPC and they ask me about software and I show them this in Ableton, they go bananas because they like, oh, that makes so much sense. So basically, your tracks are vertical. They're not horizontal like most DAWs are, and that's what confuses a lot of people. And then they see all these boxes and they're like, man, what the crap is that? I'm gonna make it plain and simple for you. Right here, this is your track. So let's say I wanted to pull this brass over and put it on track one. Now I got a track. So on your track, inside each track, you have a clip. Basically, your clip is your MIDI data for the sounds on that track. So let's say we start with clip number one. If I double click it to bring it up down here, let's say I make it 4 bars. Say I tap out my tempo, whatever I wanna use, that's fine. So I got my metronome. When it automatically arms it when you put a sound on there. I got mine set to do a count in of 2 bars. So I turn my metronome. So this isn't really a beat making video. I just want to show you something real quick. So I got my 2-bar count in, like it's customary. All right, so now we see that we got a little sequence, you know what I'm saying? We got a little something going on track one. Let's say I wanted to go to track two. Let's say I want to pull in an impulse and play some drums over that. So I go in there, find some drums. Let's say I'm going to use some of these samplified drums or whatever. So I got that. We find me a little kick. I don't even know what it sounds like. I'm just kind of pulling stuff over. Got me a little kick. I need a snare somewhere. Let's grab this snare. Alright, let's see. So, alright, so let's say we want to make something on that one. So, and now you notice how these two are lined up, because it's going to make sense in a minute. So right now, I'm going to go in here, another 4-bar joint, turn my metronome back on, get my little count in going. Hang with me. So that's done. So now we got two tracks, right? All right, so let's say that's all I want for my chorus. Anything that goes horizontally and lines up, think of that as your pattern. That's each separate pattern, you know, or each separate sequence in your pattern. So say you start with your chorus. So you can come over here and label it. I'll go over here and label that joint chorus. Let's say the next part I'm gonna do is, you know, or that would probably be my intro, actually. Let's say the next one I'm gonna do is gonna be my chorus. I go here and label the chorus. So now I got my chorus going, right? Look, so what you can do, if you push hold control and drag, I can drag this down just like you do on your MPC or your ASR or any kind of beat machines or any kind of hardware. You copy your pattern to the next slot and work on it some more. So I can copy both of these down. I actually highlighted both of them. I didn't want to do that, so I just delete that. So now look, that's my first. The top row is my first pattern. Here's my second pattern. Let's say on my second pattern, I wanna add some hi-hats. Do I got my hi-hat? I gotta, arm it. Let's say I wanna add my hi-hats to this one. So we right there, we're gonna record in there. Now, as you can see, I've already started building my patterns. I got my intro. Whenever I want to change, I got my chorus. Just like that. That's the simplest way I can explain it, and I'm telling you, it makes so much sense. It makes your workflow so quick because you just work down. So your tracks are right there, each track, every lane is a track, every column is a track, every row is a different pattern, other people use it differently, there's tons of ways to use Ableton. This is not the only way to use it, this is not the only way to set it up, but I found this to be the easiest way, coming from hardware to software, and the best DAW to make that transition, because it still lets you work like you used to working, copying your patterns, making your changes, all that stuff, and you just build up your clips, and you can build it up. You can go into verse right here. You can say this is gonna be your verse, or whatever, and you can come and you can keep adding whatever you want. Say you wanted to come up here and add a different, instrument on your, you want to add some keys to, You can just have that on your, say you want to copy that, do a control, copy that, control, copy that, keep doing that, my bad, but let's say you want to put something over here, say you just want a verse to have, your little, oops, you know what I forgot to do, I didn't set my length, but anyway, so you do that. Now you can just add the organ to the verse. Now, like I said, I'm not really trying to make a beat right here. I'm just trying to show you so you understand it and understand why I think Ableton is the dopest DAW out there, period. Especially for dudes and females coming from hardware and used to working in a pattern, make a pattern, copy the pattern, edit the pattern, and build your song that way. You see, I already built my intro. You can turn that off. I already got my intro. I can go straight to my chorus. And I got my verse already. Just like that. So if you realize that your tracks go like this, and each lane is going to be a separate track, and you set your sounds up that way, and then your patterns go across, you can coordinate these, you can color code them, so the top one is whatever. I mean, you can do whatever you want. You can just launch your sequences like that. Now when you're ready to record, you can record it. It'll record everything linearly into the range feature, so it'll have your tracks already laid out for you. So when you're ready to track it out and separate it, you can hit record, go through, play your tracks, trigger them however you want, and it'll automatically record it over there. So I hope this helps you. A lot of people ask me about it. I know anybody that I tell this to that's used to hardware, when they see this, they go bananas. So I hope this helps you out. My boy Steve, I hope this helped you out, man. I hope people see how powerful Ableton is. I'm getting kind of long, but if you have any questions, let me know. Come over to soundsandgear.com. This is your boy St. Joe. I'm going to see y'all later.